Hi everyone, my name is Nofar from SAP Business One Product Management Team. In this video, I am going to walk you through creating a no-code build project using the SAP Business Technology Platform. A build project means we will be using a visual interface to create an app without writing any code. Once we complete this app, we will go through the steps to package it, deploy it, and finally, we will add a new tile in the web client to display this project. So let's start. So in the BTP cockpit, under the services, let's click the subscriptions. And then the SAP Build Apps. It will lead me to the main SAP build screen where you can find an old project and create a new one. Let's click on creating a new one, build an application, SAP build app, web and mobile application, and let's give our project a name. So this is the main window of our project. On the left side, you will find the name of the project. In our case, my project. In the toolbar, you will find the options to start developing your app. Let's click the data tab. This is where we integrate our project with a backend service. In our case, we will be using the service layer to connect to our data. In this step, we will choose the OData integration option, which allows us to connect to an OData service to retrieve data for our app. Once we select the OData option, we will be prompted to enter the API URL of the service layer, username, and password. The system will establish a connection to the service layer, retrieving all the available data from the backend. At this point, the only thing left for us to do is select our specific scenario. In our case, I want to display a list of items with their item codes and descriptions. So I will choose the item option from the list of available data sources. Let's save it. And I will go to the home page in the left. So the next step is design our page. The first thing to do is change the page name and the title. In the left menu, I will scroll down and choose the list items. I will change to variables and we'll define the data variables. Let's click the plus and find our items that already defined and go back to the view. Now I will choose the repeat with and we'll click the items. Save. So basically what we did is creating a new page with an item list control that connected to our item list from the service layer. Now that we have added the list and bound it to our data, it's time to configure how the data will be displayed in the list. The next step is to choose the primary and secondary labels for the items in our list. For this specific case, we want the item code to appear as the primary label and the item name as the secondary label. To do this, click the list component and in the properties panel on the right, you will see option for primary label and secondary label. So let's fill it in. Item code and item name. Right, and there we can see that there is a binding for those two properties. Let's save it. Let's go to the Navigation tab. This tab is relevant if your project contains more than one page, as it allows you to decide the order and the flow of how user will navigate through the app. In our case, we just have one page, so I will launch the app. Let's click the Launch tab, preview your app. So here is our page that contains a list of items with the item code and item name. Let's go back to the build and deploy the app. I will create a configuration, SAP Build Work Zone. Let's give it a name. Now I will build the project. Great. Now it finished, so we will download the mTAR file and we will use it in the Visual Studio Code. In the Visual Studio Code, we will open the wizard. I will choose SAP Business One Web Client and Tile Extension App. I will give an ID for this application. Version and provider. I will choose the SAP Build App. We'll fill in the module name and we'll import the mTAR package. Next, let's give this project a title. Subtitle. I will choose to open the build project in a new window. And we'll click Finish. Great, so this is our project. Let's go to the MTA archives. Here we will find the mTAR file. I will copy it and we'll go to the extension manager. Let's log in. Username, password. And here, as we all know, I will import my mTAR file. And we'll assign it to specific database. Great. Let's go to the web client. And here, under the extensions tab, we can find a new tile, click on it, and it will open our build project. Thanks everyone for watching this video. Hope you enjoy it.